So, I know this is kind of sudden, and I haven't really made any videos about this yet, but this is actually my school bus. I bought it like 4 or 5 months ago for $4,000 at a used car lot. And it's because I work 4 hours away from my parents' property up north. And it just didn't make sense for me to be spending, you know, $600 a month on a room down here that I only sleep in 5 nights a week, because I just go up north and I, you know, do my laundry and take care of housekeeping stuff. So I bought this so that I could live in it while I'm working down here. And so far, it's been just fucking fantastic. I mean, I love it. I really like, you know, having the freedom to do whatever I want, having the comfort of a bed anywhere I want, being able to travel, being able to go places with big groups of friends. Long story short, the automatic transmission blew up about 3-4 weeks ago, and as you can see, now there's a manual in it. Went pretty straightforward. I'm working my way through it. I'm actually almost done. The reason I'm making this video is to explain my next video about the pedal assembly, which goes there. And yeah, basically I need to add a clutch pedal because there is no stock replacement part that swaps in with the clutch pedal, so I'm basically on my own there, which has been the hardest part of the swap for sure. I had this shop, pretty awesome dude, Easy Go Auto in Petaluma. He did all the work for me of actually doing the swap. Unfortunately, we had to cut a little bit out of the floor, which is kind of a bummer. What I'll have to do is cut this tab out, clean up these edges, and weld in a steel box right here to all these surfaces of the floor, and that'll be like my little shifting box thing that the boot mounts to, if that makes sense. I didn't think I would have to do that, which is kind of a bummer, but it is what it is. Yeah, so it was a E40D transmission automatic, which was Ford's first electronic transmission. I was on my way to work on a Monday. I was in the coffee drive-thru line waiting to get some coffee, and as soon as I was about to pull away, I shift into drive, and I got no drive. Got no reverse, got no first gear, second gear, nothing, no drive. I was about 1 week away at that point from driving to LA to compete on the new season of BattleBots, season 2, with a friend. I was on Team Scorpios. That was a lot of fun, but it kind of made this project have to happen really quickly. So without putting too much thought into it, you know, I did a lot of research to make sure that the transmission would actually be compatible and bolt up, which is a ZF-5 transmission. So that bolted up just fine. I bought it on Craigslist, $400. Went and picked it up. I did a ton of running around, collecting parts, collecting pieces, the clutch. The master cylinder was custom aftermarket stuff. Let's see, I'm getting off track now. But yeah, basically this is my bus. I'm doing a transmission swap on it, and next up is some details about modifying the pedal assembly. But before we jump into that, let me just give you a quick tour of my bus. It's really messy right now. Like I said, this transmission thing has been nonstop. Go, 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 get it done, because I need this thing on the road and out of here as soon as possible. Zeke has been really, really nice letting me park the bus here and actually sleep at night in the bus because I have nowhere else to stay down here, and he's letting me do a lot of the work by myself here, which is super awesome. I highly recommend this dude. Anyway, here's the bus. First thing I did was make this table out of a tubi fir and some plywood. I'm not a woodworker, as you may know, but this thing has been really sturdy, really great. Obviously, it's a death trap, but school buses are death traps, so there you go. These are my two batteries. They're Trojans. Big old 6-volt acid tanks. Iota battery charger. Fancy drawing by my buddy Frosty. Got a 750-watt Harbor Freight inverter with the lifetime replacement program. Another little 400-watt, which I use in my cars and stuff normally. It had 5 seats to begin with. There were 2 more, one here and one there, but I took those 2 out. First thing I did, first configuration I ran with the bus was, rather than a couch, there was a twin bed there, and that came out to about right here. But the twin bed was sweet, but really comfy, but the couch is so much better. I'm so glad that I have the couch now. It's long enough to stretch out and be comfortable, no problem. Yeah, love the couch. My friends love the couch. Pretty sweet. I've been running this heater for a long time. These things are great. They create kind of a lot of humidity when the dew point of the air is kind of, you know, I don't really understand the science of it, but it makes the windows condensate up like crazy, which is kind of a bummer, but, you know, do what you gotta do. I have plans to have a better heater that's like an actual furnace that recirculates the air and keeps the burn air separate, but I've got a carbon monoxide meter and I've never had any problems running this thing overnight. It's actually a great device. I'm running out of time here on my phone, but, yeah, that's the school bus. Sorry I didn't make a more proper video to begin with. There was a wheelchair lift bolted in right here. A couple months after I got it, I discovered a massive crack in the frame, so I just elected to take it out for now and store it in the garage until I could get somebody to weld it up for me. That door has been really handy, that big wide thing. I love the windows, but they're all fucked up because the plastic breaks and you can't pull the things, so I gotta take the windows out. There's like 4 screws there, 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 and there, and then the thing pops out, but it's sealed in there with silicone and stuff. Anyway, my phone's about to not let me record any video, so thanks for watching, guys. All right, let's see if I can do this concisely in one take. So I'm converting my bus from an automatic to a manual transmission, and this is the original pedal assembly. Just this metal formed piece, not these pedals. These pedals are actually from a F-250 pickup truck that I've done some slight modifications to so far, mainly knocking out that pin out of the brake pedal and cutting a little finger off of the clutch pedal. So this is the original shaft that they used in the F-250 to do the pedal linkage. And so this side goes in there like that, and those 2 flats register on those 2 flats, and then a bolt holds, or a nut rather, holds it onto the shaft. So what I did is, I'm at work right now, and I'm on the Mastercam computer, and what I did is draft up the shaft. This is after I drafted up the pedal assembly. These two lines here and here represent the sheet metal and the thickness of the sheet metal in position right here and here. And then this middle piece represents the brake pedal. And this is kind of an outline of the clutch pedal. And that line right there represents where I would ideally want to mount the master cylinder, which is going to go, let me see if I can jam this up here, something like that. Okay, so the original pedal assembly with that clutch pedal used this, which goes sort of like this on the F250 pedal assembly, but it's got this bend in it, so I was wondering maybe, because this, at first glance, the shaft looked way too long to work or be workable in this pedal assembly, because the F250 one was totally different. But I'm just mocking things up and testing things out, and ideally what I wanted to do is mount the master cylinder about, say, that rod right there from the edge of the sheet metal there would be about like 1.5 inches. So just to see if that shaft could be worked, which was a suggestion by my boss, just to because I was wondering how I was gonna, I had a whole different plan initially, but yeah, hold on, my phone's about to stop recording here. And my original plan was not to use the shaft actually, and make a custom shaft, because at first thought I thought I would be able to mount this master cylinder like somewhere in here, you know, weld some brackets or whatever, and then I could basically just mount it directly to the clutch pedal. But there's actually not enough room under the dash right here on this side of the pedal assembly, which normally goes like that, and then the steering column goes sort of right through this radius right here, and that, those four bolts mount to the firewall, and the brake master is right in the center of that. So I have to mount the clutch cylinder on this side and have a shaft that goes through connecting to the clutch pedal, and then the brake pedal just floats on that shaft in the middle. So here's what I determined is, so here's the ideal scenario for the pedal assembly, which is right here is where I would like to mount the master. Here is drafting of this shaft. You got the splines on one end and the two flats on the other. And so check this out. Let's do this right here. Go up to X form, translate. The exposure is not really cutting it here, so we want to move from that point. Oh wait, no, shit. Paying attention too much to the phone. Select all this. Translate from here to here. Hit okay. So there you go. So this is where the shaft lands with the pedals, and this little box right here represents the flats. Come on, phone, focus. There we go. Not so much. Holy shit. Okay, there's the flats. Yep, flats. They go into the pedal like that. So there's this piece welded on the one side, and then that piece is the flats. So this piece right here would be the one with the flats, or this piece would be the one with the diameter on the pedals. Those are spaced 7/8 away from this side, and then it goes through the pedal assembly over to the other side. And now you can see the splines where, let's see where to go. Shit, what did I do with it? This thing. So this thing originally was just a press on to those splines. You can do it, phone. Man, my iPhone was way better at focusing than this fucking note is. But yeah, so that was, you know, bolted onto the splines of the shaft. And so, look at how close that matchup is. Pretty sweet. Now this one has a bend to it, so I don't know if it being on the splines there would line up with that line. I don't think so. It's way too much. Basically, what I'm going to end up doing is making a flat version of this, and then that will attach onto my master cylinder there with a little clevis style thing. And yeah, but basically I just wanted to show you how close this old shaft from the F-250 lines up with what I want to do on my busting, which is going to make it a whole lot easier to get these pedals working on the bus. Yeah, thanks for watching. One thing I forgot to mention, what I'm going to do is the pedal in here has a little bit of wiggle room. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drill these holes out to so that this shaft fits through it. And I'm actually going to go a little bit bigger than that. What I'm going to do is I'm going to braze little bushings onto the side of this right here. So they'll be like brazed onto the side here, and then they'll come out like 875, which is the distance from the side of the sheet metal here to where I want the clutch pedal to mount. So there'll be that spacer right here. You know, I'll make a nice big old chamfer on it. And then this shaft will slide through to the other side. Same thing on this side. There'll be another brass bushing, bronze bushing, whatever, brazed onto the side to get the distance between here, this line, which is the center line of the clutch master cylinder, to the other side. So that will hold the shaft from wiggling back and forth, because this will be here, that'll be there, you'll have the bushings there, bushing there, and then so you'll bolt the clutch pedal onto this end of the shaft, you'll slide the whole assembly through, put a couple brass washers here and here to hold the brake pedal centered on the shaft, and then it'll slide through this bushing, and then this piece, which I make, will have another washer between it and that bushing, and then that will bolt on, and then the whole thing will be captured between those two brass bushings, which are brazed onto the side of the pedal assembly. So that's my plan. What do you think?
Yeah, awesome. Thank you.
Right down.
There's actually a little plant growing, not just moss, but a little root of plant growing out of its whatever this is. whatever that is.
For its sinuses.
No, that's.
Alrighty, folks.
It's gotta be before something. It goes back to the eyes, so it's probably the.
Downtown. you know, where we used to go, you know, like we used to do it, down there, you know what I'm saying, baby? We're gonna go down there, that's where the option is, baby, you know what I'm saying? We're gonna go down there.
Little butt puckering. Oh, it's still hot. You gonna sit for me? Yeah. Not too bad, not too bad. Oh yeah, that's what I like to see. Oh yeah. Nice flow. Delicious. Almost had a catastrophe the first time I tried this one. I had a shaft, a steel shaft going through both pieces to align them, and my plan was to fusion weld a couple little tacks around and then pull the shaft out. Well, fusion welding wasn't happening because my tip was too small to flow this giant chunk here, and I decided to stick a little braze rod on there, and then it went through and wicked down to the shaft. And then as soon as I tried to tap the shaft with the hammer, it wouldn't move, and then I started freaking out. Anyway, what we ended up doing is that this one was already tacked. That one was the stubborn one. And so what I did is I turned down a broom handle, literally, and stuck it through this one so it was sticking out about an inch over here. And then clamped that side in the vise, preheated that one on the bench till it was cherry red, dropped it on the broom handle, and started brazing real quick before the broom handle lost alignment from just burning away. And, well, I think we did it, because I'm going to press in a plastic bushing there that's going to go down to 780, and that's 1 inch right there. And then I'll run a reamer through the whole thing at once in the mill, and, yeah, should work good. Something.